this piece which I wrote for all the men working in Navy. It shows how it feels to love a man who is away from home most of the time. So here it goes. Fall in love with a man of sea and see how it feels. Writing long emails every day and discussing your all-day activities. Telling him how you feel. Writing him how much you miss his presence. Every day in a different way. Making out time to reply to those long emails like it's your favorite time of the day. There are no said and unsaid terms and conditions of your relationship. Fall in love with a man of sea because the 6 months he's away, he has got hell lot of work to do and you have got hell lot of things to say. Just the thought that he is writing to you will make your day. You will realize being happy is very easy. You'll wonder why your friends keep whining and nagging all the time with their partners to meet. You will love him even more when he'll guess all your worries. From thousands and thousands miles apart, he'll make you smile, cry and laugh. From so far through his emails, you will fall harder for him. Trust me, I have. Fall in love with a man of sea because he'll love you so much that you'll never feel lonely. And when he calls, in a month or two, that satellite phone call will be a blessing from God. For keeping your networks intact, your hearts connect, you won't know where the time's flying. And our call will feel like few seconds just passed by. And the call will always cut in mid-conversation. But you'll love that. Of course, with a little frustration, but you'll love how your man completes your side of story in the next mail he sends. Like he already knew everything you wanted to tell. Fall in love with a man of sea. Some days though, he won't be able to make it to write to you. Some days, and on those days, he'll be feeling equally empty and low as he could not make it to read yours. Some days he won't be able to complete his sleep. Some days he'll just wake up annoyed and agitated. But on those days, he'll write to you completely annoyed. But don't you worry. I bet you'll love that too. Because you don't get to see the annoyed him very often. You'd rather feel lucky to read those annoyed emails he sends and honestly reply him your emotions. Because the truth is, whatever you reply, happy, sad or annoyed, the next mail he'll write to you with all the love he carries in his heart for you. So even if he does not say, you should know that you mean the world to him as he means to you. Fall in love with a man of sea, for he'll tell you this love is a journey. You'll ride with him on the glittering oceans, under the tantalizing sunlight and the moonlight. But at times, when your oceans apart, that's when your love will grow stronger and so will your heart. Fall in love. Fall in love with a man of sea, for he knows how love and time do not wait for him. He knows how quickly these days flies. He knows how love needs no calls, no meetings, just your understanding and a little time. To keep it moving, to keep it going. Fall in love with a man of sea because when he leaves, a part of you leaves with him. There is no responsible man than him as he maturely manages his hectic work and your feelings. He makes sure that you're never hurt. He takes care of all your gifts and stuff. The little poems and songs that you wrote. The greeting cards and rose. The birthday presents and your heart. He carries them all safely into the sea and brings them back home with him. You see, he keeps you so, so close to him. So try falling in love with a man of sea as you learn to live with and without him. You'll learn to be dependent and yet be so independent. You will learn to wait. And every time that your phone rings, your heart will miss a beat. You will hold your breath until you see his name. So fall in love with a man of sea. for once. Thank you. This another poem which is very short, and it is called White. And I got this idea of writing the poem White because I consider it white as a color. We all do. So one day when I was looking for synonym of white, it was first synonym that appeared was colorless. So I got to know that white is also called colorless. Here it goes. Colors do not entice me. Only colorless does. White is the colorless color, combining all the visible rays, reflecting, recognized by the eye, the light that burns bright from dawn to dusk and long after twilight. It's the color of the cold, snowy winter, of the warm daylight summer, of the loss of a life, of the giga of celebration nights, of flowers, of peace, of the angels in the sky, the color that makes me feel alive, grieve over demise. That colorless color is white. Thank you. In the end, I just want to thank the Social House for giving me this opportunity, my first ever open mic, and I just loved it. And he was asking the question to her that how it feels being here. It's feeling like it's a home. It's like I belong here. So thank you so much.